everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Carrie, this channel is all about Hawaii food and family, and today we'll be making a simple bento box that we will be taking to the airport tomorrow. So sometimes Reid and I, we don't like the airport food in general. Just now with a child, it's always good to travel with a meal. So I'm going to be making a salted salmon along with some other things that will go along in our bento. So keep watching and see what we make. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you like my content, and follow me on Instagram as well. I post a lot on my Instagram stories, and you can see just the day-to-day life that we are living. So follow me there. My Instagram handle is carrie.tyra. So all I'm doing here is cutting the salmon into about 2-inch sections. This is the wild salmon that you can buy from Costco, the frozen section. That's the one we generally get, Alaska wild salmon, I think it is. So I'm gonna put some sake in the bottom of my container here. And the sake that I'm using, I think this is actually sake to drink, but it's the Yaegaki Sake Junmai. So it's actually really good sake. But this is all I have right now. And I'm just gonna place the salmon in here for about 10 minutes. And we're just gonna let it soak in the sake, just to give it like extra flavor. I particularly like to make this while or for traveling, because even though there's just a little bit of preparation the day before, the next day, so tomorrow when we actually have to go on the airplane, all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take it out of the fridge and I'm gonna bake it for a little bit, and that's it, and it'll be ready by then. So it's a great simple salmon to make and perfect for a small bento. Okay, so it's been about 10 minutes and I'm gonna take my salmon out and I'm just going to pat them all dry, and then I'm gonna salt them. So let me know in the comments too if you are the type of person that makes, like, brings food to the airport, or are you the type of person to go there and buy? Usually, honestly, we are the type of people to go and buy food, but you know, sometimes it is nice to just bring your own, and to be prepared. Especially with a toddler now, I feel like you just never know, and you just have to be ready. We're gonna add on some. We're gonna add on some salt. And we're salting both sides to get all the moisture out, so it kind of like dries it out. Then I'm gonna stick it in my container here. Then we're gonna stick it back in the fridge and bake it tomorrow morning. Okay, the next thing that it goes great, obviously, in a bento is some tamagoyaki. And I'm just gonna be making 3 eggs, I think. So I like to just add like a dash of shoyu, a dash of mirin, and just to give it a little bit more depth of flavor. Okay, so for my egg, I'm just gonna add a dash of shoyu, and a little bit of mirin. A little bit of milk. And sugar, which I forgot to take out. A bit of sugar, just a tad. Whenever I make tamagoyaki, I never really use any measurements. I always do things to taste, and it always seems to come out pretty good. So I would just recommend that you do it to your liking. And how I'm making the tamagoyaki is I'm just pouring a little bit of the egg into the pan, and I'm cooking that up and rolling it over, and I'm adding more of the egg and doing the same steps, repeating the same steps over and over here. Essentially, so it literally becomes rolled egg as you cut it. Before we go on a trip, I also like to kind of use what's in my fridge and, you know, just clean it out a little bit and try to eat as much as we can of what's in there. And so I found this broccoli in there, so I just wanted to make like a broccoli salad for a side dish tomorrow for our bento. So I'm just going to be cutting up some broccoli, adding a little bit of sauce, the teriyaki flavored sauce with some sesame oil. I'm going to throw it in my salad spinner with some veggie wash, and then I'm going to just boil it up for a little bit and add some sauce. So while my broccoli is boiling, I'm going to be putting together the sauce. So here I'm adding shoyu and sugar, a dash of sesame oil, and chopped garlic. And that's it for our sauce. I'm going to mix it together and add it to the broccoli. Poop. Taste my sauce here. Nice. So we're just gonna throw this sauce over our broccoli when it's done and call it a day. Want to try some broccoli? Here. Try it.
Uh-oh.
So you say broccoli?
Broccoli.
Too good. You don't want it? Oh, very good. So it's later on in the evening now, and Reid is putting Ellie to bed, and so I'm going to put together our musubi for tomorrow, and it's just very, very simple. I'm just gonna also salt the rice a little bit, just a little bit. Okay. I also picked up this ume from Don Quixote today, and it just looked really good. And I love ume, like I love all of that kind of stuff, like lihimoy and, you know, just that savory goodness that you get from it smells so good. Reid, on the other hand, doesn't like this or doesn't care for these things, so I probably will only just use one. But this one is the hachimitsu something. But it was in the refrigerated section, and excited to try this one. In this bowl here, I just have warm water with some salt in it. I'm just gonna make plain musubis. And my mom taught me how to do this actually quite a few years ago. Just get your hand in the salt water, and all you're doing is like making like triangle shapes with your fingers. And you can also leave it bare like this if you really wanted to. I am going to put some furikake on the side just to give it some color. Roll it in, furikake. And it gives it us a little bit of more flavor. And there you have it, ta-da! I made plain ones with furikake on the outside for Reid, and for myself, I added ume in the middle. And for Ellie, I made plain and ume, and I made them extra small though for her tiny hands. There's something also nostalgic about making musubi and like going on a flight. I feel like when my grandparents were around, they would do this all the time. You know, like if they were traveling, if they were going somewhere, they would always make like musubi and all of this. And so this kind of, this activity reminds me so much of them. Okay, so to actually separate everything, I think I'm just gonna use wax paper. Because I was thinking about making it like super aesthetic and, you know, having everyone have their own bento boxes, but we're just gonna save on containers and all of that and just time. So we're just not gonna do it this time. I'm gonna cut the tamagoyaki that I made earlier today. And this you can just eat cold. Let's see how it came out. Oh, not bad. That's what it looks like inside. I'm gonna try a little piece. Tell you how the flavor is. Has like a little bit of sweetness. Broccoli, which Ellie actually really enjoyed. After I made this, she kept on saying broccoli, broccoli. So she really enjoyed the flavor. I think not so much the broccoli, but she likes that savory shoyu sesame oil flavor. Mmm, good. Our main event is the salmon, which I would like to put here. Hopefully it fits. And then I also wanted to bring some apple on the side of that. So I'm gonna finish plating this tomorrow morning, but this is so far what we're taking. This is so far what we're gonna be taking with us on the airplane. So just to give you some ideas, super simple, super easy to do, but sometimes it's just better to have homemade food than, you know, going to Burger King or something that's just, you know, that's sometimes that's the only thing open too. So yeah, a little bit more nutritious and delicious. I'll catch you guys in the morning when I finish our family bento. Good morning, everyone. It is the next morning. So I salted our salmon overnight. Some aluminum foil on the bottom of our pan for easy cleanup, as people say. And we're just gonna bake this in the oven at 425 degrees for about 10 to 12 minutes. Oh, there is our oven, it's ready. It's ready, super fast. Let's see how it turned out. March. Okay. So it looks good. They definitely shrank a little bit. Okay, so I'm just gonna try a little bit of the salmon, salted salmon. Oh. And it comes off. It kind of like dries it out a lot because of the salt and just because of leaving overnight. Hmm. Good. Mm-hmm. It kind of reminds me of the ones that you would get like in the train station a little bit, just, you know, where it's a little bit drier because we kind of took out all the water, but it still has a lot of flavor. And all it is just salt, sake and salt. All right, so we are gonna now add our salmon to our family bento. We have our musubi, we have our tamago, we have our broccoli, and then we're gonna just add the salmon. But I'm amazed at how much it actually did shrink. It's like so much smaller. And now it's all stuck to our... Okay. Three. Four. Okay, so we're going to enjoy this at the airport. I hope you guys like this video. Make sure you like my channel and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!